The count blank function in DAX counts the number of rows in a column that contain a value which is a blank. In this first example, I'm using count blank over customer name. So I'm counting the number of customers whose name is blank. It is either a blank or an empty string. You see the result 276, which is the same result that you can obtain with calculate. You can use calculate, count rows of customers, and then you add the condition that checks that the customer name is either a blank or an empty string. Remember that in DAX, the condition customer name equals empty string is true for both blanks and empty strings. If you are using strings, then blank and empty strings, they are the same. If, on the other hand, you are using numbers or dates or any numeric column, then there is a difference between zero and blank. This measure, count blank of a customer birth date, is operating over a date, therefore it will consider zero and blank as two different values. You can count the number of customers that have a birth date and compare it with the version that uses is blank. In this case, zero and blank, they are treated in a different way. Speaking about count blank, it is important to remember the difference between blank and empty strings, because most of the times you will be counting strings. Look at the result here. We have a count blank of customer name that reports 67. But how many customers have a blank and how many customers have an empty string? If you need to compute that number, you need to use a different condition. Using calculate count rows, you can check for customer name equals to empty string or strictly equal to an empty string. The result with equal empty string is the same as count blank, whereas the result that using strictly equal returns 33, which is much less than 67, because 33 is the number of customers that only have an empty string. We are not considering blanks. The blanks are counted using this other condition that uses strictly equal to blank. Strictly equal makes a difference between the empty string and the blank. Or you can use the isBlank function that provides the very same result as strictly equal blank. So remember, there are differences in the way count blank counts blanks and empty strings between numbers and strings. And again, this is the reason why we prefer not to use count blank, because it has this logic that you always need to remember, and we prefer to use the longer version that uses calculate. That way, you can specify in a clearer and more granular way exactly what you want to count by using equal, strictly equal, or whatever condition you might need.